Hi, I'm Laila, and today we'll be doing a quick flow for back pain relief. So expect it to be gentle, slow paced. Bring your mat and let's get started. Have any comfortable seated position here. Roll your shoulders up, back and down to maintain an open chest, keeping the shoulders relaxed down. Close your eyes and start breathing in and out through the nose. Start connecting with your breath here. And think of inhaling deeply, filling the lungs to the maximum capacity, and exhaling very slowly. And whenever you're ready, we're going to start opening the eyes up. Doing a couple of shoulder rotations here, bringing the shoulders up, back and down, and two more, up, back and down, last one, up, back and down, into the opposite direction, from the back, bring them up, forward and down, two more, last one, and come back to neutral back. Always think that someone is lifting you up from the crown of your head to maintain a straight and long spine. Alright, and from here we're going to inhale the arms up. Lengthen your spine, stretch your arms and gaze up. And gently exhale to release the arms. And one more, inhale arms up. And exhale to release all the way down. Last one, inhale, and exhale to release all the way down. Bringing the palms on top of the knees here, we're going to inhale to send the chest forward, keeping the shoulders down towards the back, looking up. Then this time, exhale to round your spine, tuck your chin to your chest, and go far as much as you can. Alright, we have two more rounds here. I'll show you how the spine should be curved from the side. So we have the palms on the knees here. We inhale to send the chest forward and look up, keeping the elbows and the shoulders down. And then we exhale to round the spine, scooping the chest and the belly. And last round, inhale, chest forward. And exhale to push your knees away, lock down to your belly. And gently roll yourself all the way back to straight spine. And from here, we're going to bring the palms forward, pushing forward, coming to Gable Four. Hands under shoulders, knees are hip width apart, and relax your feet here. We're going for five rounds of cat-cow breathing. We inhale to look up, sending the tailbone up and dropping the belly down. And exhale to round your spine, tuck your chin to your chest and push the mat away. We have four more. Inhale into cow, drop your belly. And exhale into cat, lift your upper and middle back up to the ceiling. Follow your own pace here, keep inhaling into cow and exhaling into cat. We have two more rounds here. Exhale to cow. Last one, inhale. And exhale to cow. Coming back to table pose, flat back. Inhale the right arm up, open your chest to the side. And exhale to thread the needle, bringing the right shoulder and the right cheek down on the mat. Bend your left elbow. And from here you can extend your left arm forward. Regulate your breath. And bringing the left arm close to the head. And inhale, right arm all the way back up. And exhale to drop your palm down. And we're going for the other side. So whenever you're ready, inhale, left arm up. And exhale to thread the needle, dropping the left shoulder and the left cheek down to the mat. And again from here, feel free to extend your right arm forward. Regulate your breath here. And again, we're going to bring the right palm close to the face. Inhale, left arm up. And exhale to drop your palm down. And from here, we're going to connect the big toes together. Sit on the heels and stretch your arms for child pose. 5 breaths here. Feel free to keep your arms extended or to relax your elbows down to the mat. And keep on pushing your hip towards the back and sit on your heels. Make sure your neck is relaxed. We have one more breath here. Keeping child pose, we're going to start extending the arms towards the right side. Move your upper body, keep pushing your hip to your heels, and stretch as much as you can. Regulate your breath in and out through the nose. And again, we're moving to the center of the mat, arms forward, and then taking the step to the left, stretching the side, relaxing the neck down. And gently moving back to the center, lifting all the way back up into table pose, tucking the toes here and pushing for downward dog. And gently bending one knee at a time, moving the hip from side to side. This time, let's try to push both heels down to the mat, maintaining a flat back here. So think of lifting the tailbone up to the ceiling, stretching the legs, sending the chest towards the knees as much as you can. Inhale to lift your heels off the mat, and exhale to bend your knees, going all the way back down into table pose. And again, from here, relax your feet, connecting the big toes. We're going to sit down and relax in child pose. Pushing the hip to the heels. Inhale to start looking forward at your fingers. Taking one step with the palms closer to your knees. And just like the cat-cow breathing, we're going to inhale to send the chest forward, shoulders down. And exhale to round your spine, chin to chest, and start lifting your belly off your thighs. And one more. Inhale forward, arch your back, look forward. And exhale, round your spine, chin to chest, belly off the thighs. Last one here, inhale, and feel that you're pulling the mat towards you, and exhale, push the mat away around your spine, and coming back to flat back, we're going to take a step forward with the right palm, bringing the left arm beneath, turning the palm up, relax your head down on the mat. Keep pushing your hip back towards the heels and relaxing. Breathing in and out through the nose. And again, inhale your arm back to the center and exhale to do the other side, bringing the right down, shoulder and head down the mat. And again, inhale back forward. Bring your palms a little bit closer to the knees, bringing the knees completely together, keeping the big toes together. We're going to drop the forehead down, bringing the arms all the way towards the back into child pose. Relax your shoulders here. Keep your palms looking up. And gently from here, think of tucking your chin to your chest. Moving the crown of the head down to the mat as close to your knees as you can. Hold your heels and inhale to lift your hip off the heels into rabbit pose. Make sure you're not pressuring the crown of your head over your neck here. Have a breath and exhale to relax all the way down, bringing the forehead down on the mat to relax the shoulders. And again, bringing the arms forward, lift yourself up through table pose, tucking the toes, going to our downward dog. And gently from here, inhale right leg up, go as high as you can. And exhale to shift your weight forward, bringing the foot between the palms. From here, we want to drop the back heel towards the side. And inhale your arms up, going to our warrior two. So here, the right toes are pointing forward, left toes are pointing towards the sides. Try to go as deep as you can, maintaining an open hip, arms parallel to the mat, and gaze at your right fingers. From here, inhale to extend the front knee, lean forward, and go down to find your Trikonasana. You can have your palms on the shin or maybe all the way down to the mat. Most importantly, to bend from the hip, maintaining an open chest. Both shoulders are aligned and maybe gazing up if you can. Have a deep breath in here and exhale to bend the front knee, dropping the left palm down, wrapping the foot, close your hip, lifting the back heel off the mat, and push it all the way back to downward dog. Feel free to lift your heels off the mat, bending the knee here. Extending the knees, dropping the heels down. We're going to inhale the left leg up. And exhale to shift your weight forward, bringing the foot between the palms. Dropping the right heel to the side. Whenever you're ready, inhale your arms up into warrior two. And again, arms are parallel to the mat. Right toes pointing forward. Left are pointing towards the top of the mat. Keep relaxing the shoulders here, regulate your breath, and look at your left fingers. And from here, inhale to extend the front knee, and exhale to lean forward, bending from the hip, going to our Trikonasana. You can have a block or a book here, or again, you can have your palm on your shin, keeping the chest open. We're sending the right shoulder towards the back, left shoulder forward as much as you can, gazing. Have a deep breath in here and exhale to micro bend the front knee, dropping the right palm down, wrapping the foot, lift the back heel off the mat, close your hip here. Now right hand from here. We're going to send the weight to the left foot, taking a step forward, coming into our flat back. And exhale to round your spine, bend your knees, let your head be heavy and relax here. Now right, gently inhale to roll yourself all the way back up. Keeping the chin to the chest, letting the head come up last, and relax your shoulders. We're going to take a step towards the back, sending the feet to the edges of the mat and turning the toes out. Alright, and from here, inhale your arms up, lengthen your spine. We're going to keep the palms together and only think of your upper back here, reaching as high as you can, engaging the glutes. Start sending the arms towards the back, look up, chest up. Have a deep breath in and exhale to come back to neutral. Bend your knees, round your spine, go all the way down, head is heavy. And again, gently roll yourself all the way back up. Inhale, arms up. Reach as high as you can, start opening the chest forward and only feel it from the upper back. Glutes are engaged, we don't want to be here, keep tucking the tailbone in. And gently come back to the center, round your spine, go all the way down, let your head be heavy. And from here reach out to the opposite elbows and gently start rocking from side to side. Release your arms down, keeping the palms or the fingertips down to the mat. Start bending your knees, going to our yogi squat. If your knees are not down on the mat, that's completely fine. It's better if you bring a towel here to rest your heels. Bend your chest forward and lengthen your spine. And from here, try to engage more glutes, lifting all the way back up, arms up, lengthen your spine. And from here, we want to hold one wrist with the thumb and the index finger. Inhale, reach as high as you can, and then exhale to stretch to your side. Try to control your hip from not going to the side. We want to keep it where it is, just stretching to the side. Inhale back to the center, switching sides, reach as high as you can and start stretching. Inhale back to the center, palms together to the center of your heart. Thank you for watching. Namaste.